Take a look at this comment that I received from my video titled Struggles of Being an Introvert. You have a YouTube channel, buddy. You are not an introvert. This is a great reminder that most people still have a kind of distorted view of what the terms introvert and extrovert mean. Now, I'm not 100% positive why this person attributed being on YouTube as a clear sign that you are not an introvert. But based on how I've heard other people describe the term, my guess is that it's because being an introvert is generally associated with being shy, being quiet, and not wanting attention. But the Latin root intro means inward, and vertere means to turn, which gives you the meaning turning inwards. Extrovert, of course, is the opposite, meaning to turn outwards. These two words were popularized by the well-known psychologist Carl Jung in a book that he wrote in 1921 called Psychological Types, where he explained that this amounted to a matter of energy, both where it's directed and where it comes from. Introverts derive their energy from their own internal world of thoughts, ideas, and feelings, and tend to get exhausted from social interaction. Extroverts, on the other hand, get their energy from the outer world and get energized by social interaction. Based on these definitions, now ask yourself these questions. Is it possible to be, for example, charismatic, energetic, confident, and a leader, and be someone that needs a lot of time to themselves to recharge? Yes, because if you look deep enough, those traits are mutually exclusive from how you draw your energy. Take a listen to this conversation between Oprah Winfrey and Amy Schumer.
Let me guess, you're an introvert.
I'm an introvert!
Yeah, people are confused about, you know, but how could you get up in front of so many people? It's different.
Gail, but she is a true extrovert. She gets energy from people.
And we get sucked dry.
And I get sucked dry.
Again, these outward-facing characteristics of shy or quiet, confident or loud, don't necessarily equate to introvert or extrovert. For me, I've finally started to admit to myself that I need way more alone time than most people I know. Like, I become a worse version of myself when I don't create that space to be alone. I can sneak away from a party because I feel drained, but then when I get home, I'll stay up for hours because being alone just brings me back to life. I am definitely more of an introvert, but I took public speaking courses because I liked the idea of conveying my thoughts and doing something that a lot of other people are afraid to do. I like going to music festivals surrounded by thousands of people, or going for a night out with complete strangers while traveling and staying in hostels. To me, these are investments of energy that serve a deeper purpose. But I am more introverted because I need an even greater investment of alone time before or after those kinds of activities. And though having a YouTube channel might seem like an extroverted thing to do because you're putting yourself out in front of potentially hundreds, thousands, or even millions of people, I did research for, wrote the script for, and recorded this video by spending hours on a Friday night alone with a bottle of wine. And I loved it. And finally, watch this clip of Carl Jung himself.
There is no such thing as a pure extrovert or a pure introvert. Those are only terms to designate a certain tendency, for instance, the tendency to be more influenced by environmental influences or more influenced by the subject.
So what are the key takeaways from this video? One, that the terms introvert and extrovert describe whether you tend to draw energy from being alone with your own inner world or from other people and your external environment, and two, that we are all capable of adapting, evolving, and existing for periods of time in both of those worlds. Let's use these opposing terms as a starting point for better self-understanding. They can help us build an awareness of our own personal needs and why we may or may not currently be the healthiest versions of ourselves. But also, let's be open to the idea that all of us lie somewhere in an ever-changing spectrum of gray in between those two extremes. In the end, it's all about self-reflection and creating a life that works for us rather than against us. What do you think about the introvert versus extrovert concept? Have the definitions helped you understand yourself better at all? Leave a comment down below and let me know. And if you thought this topic was fascinating, consider hitting that subscribe button. It will really help me to continue making more content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.